A very pleasant morning, children, and I welcome you all again to today's session of English literature. We are going to continue with the Merchant of Venice, Act 4, Scene 1. I am doing Merchant of Venice in continuation so that you people can understand. Because if there is breakage, if we stop in between and then we again restart, then you will not be able to form the connection between the different acts. That is why we are doing it on stretch. We complete Act 4, Scene 1, then we will switch to either short stories or poems or even language. Okay? So, talking about till now we have done where yesterday we had done Portia's speech, where Portia had said that the quality of mercy is not with everyone. Everyone does not possess the quality of being merciful towards everyone, but it is restricted. It is restricted to individuals. Some individuals, they possess quality of being merciful towards some individuals. Even the greatest of kings, they don't have quality of showing mercy towards others. So she has said, as a lawyer, she has disguised herself, and she has said that when the mercy is combined with the power of the king, it is something which is even above the sceptre, that is the crown of the crown of the king. And that is why she says that she expects Shylock to show mercy on Antonio. Then Shylock says, it is page number 172, line number 213. Line number 213, page number 172 in your textbook. Shylock says, my deeds upon my head I crave the law, the penalty and forfeit of my bond. Shylock says that whatever I am expecting, whatever I am demanding, let me face the consequences. I am ready to face the consequences, but as of now, I want justice. I want justice, that is, I want whatever is mentioned in the will, I want to go according to the terms and the conditions of the will or the bond. Portia, is he not able to discharge the money? Portia is inquiring from Shylock that is Antonio not capable of discharging the money? Is Antonio not capable of giving the money to you? Then, wait a minute. Then, Bassanio says, yes, here I tender it for him in the court. Tender means pay. Tender means pay or present. Tender means pay or present. Tender means pay or present. Bassanio says that here is the money that I am going to present on his behalf in the court. Yes, twice the sum, and it is double the sum of money that Antonio was expected to give to Shylock. It is double of that money. If that will not suffice, suffice means sufficient or enough. Now Antonio says that Bassanio says that if that will not suffice, that is the money that he is going to give to Shylock for the money that was being borrowed by Antonio. If he is not accepting the sum of total amount, then he is ready to give double of that money. And if that will not suffice, if that will also not be enough, if doubling the amount will also not be enough, then he says, I would be bound to pay it 10 times over. Now he is saying that I will multiply that sum into 10, and whatever that amount will come, I am ready to pay that much amount for Antonio. On forfeit of my hands, my head and my heart. And if I fail, on forfeit means on the condition that if I fail to do so, I will give my hand, head and heart If this will not suffice, it must appear. And if this is not also, if this is also not enough, then it might give the feeling, it might appear. That malice bears down truth, that jealousy brings down truth, that sometimes jealousy overpowers truth. If this is not enough, that is, even if I give 10 times the amount of what actual sum was, and if after giving that 10 times, even if something is demanded, if I give my head and heart, then if that is also not sufficient, then it might give, it will give the feeling, that often jealousy, that is malice means the jealousy that is there in somebody's heart, it often overpowers truth, it often sometimes overpowers reality or truth. And I beseech you, and I request you, rest upon the law to your authority, to do a great right, to do a little wrong, and curb this cruel devil of his will. Now he's saying, I beseech you, I request to you, rest once the law, interpret once the law, means make, derive meaning out of the law. Interpret means to derive meaning out of the law to your own authority, according to the power that has been given to you by the court. You try to derive authority from that power, derive authority to do a great right, to do a great justice. You try to interpret the law according to you, because the power has been given to you, and in that way, if you are able to do so, then you are going to do a great justice. Justice means you are going to be impartial. Do a little wrong. When you are interpreting, try to interpret it in such a way that you give you do justice to the law, and then do little wrong. Do not do anything which can be of higher, which can be at fault, and curb this cruel devil. And curb means deprive. And deprive this cruel devil of the will. And deprive this cruel devil of the condition of the bond. Portia, it must not be there. It must not be. There is no power in Venice. Portia is not saying that it must not be means it is not possible. There is no power in Venice. It must not be. There is no power in Venice can alter a decree establishment. Now he's saying, Portia is acting as a lawyer, and she's saying that it cannot be, it is not possible for me to do so. Why it is not possible to do so? She's saying that there is no such power. There is no one in Venice who is as powerful, who can alter the decree establishment. Decree establishment means the highest authority of giving justice, that is the court or the law. No one has the power to overpower or alter that. No one has the power to do that according to the Venetian law. It will be recorded as recorded for a precedent. It will be recorded for as an example. For a precedent means as an example. It will be recorded as an example. And many an error by the same example will rush into the state. It cannot be. Now Portia is saying that if I alter it, then it will be a sort of example for error. It will act as a sort of example, and people will take into account this judgment, this interpretation, and then they will come and they will also challenge the laws of Venice, and it will cause error in the Venetian law, and it will this act of mine will act as an example for letting such errors creep into the Venetian law, will rush into the state, and it cannot be. And it will actually challenge the governing authority of the state, and it cannot be done. It is impossible for me to do so. Shylock, O Daniel, come to judgment. Yea, O Daniel, O wise young judge, how I do honor thee. Now, Daniel is a person who was known, Daniel is actually a biblical character who was known to give judgment, a very fair judgment. And that is why Shylock has taken name of Daniel, and he's saying it is a Daniel is a biblical character, and that is why Shylock has taken his name and saying that I am asking Daniel to come now, because they are trying to deprive justice. They are trying to deprive me of justice. So I am asking Daniel to come now to help me attain justice, to help me get justice. O wise young judge, how do I honor thee? O wise young judge, how much I respect you. How do I honor thee means how much I respect you. Portia, I pray you, let me look upon the bond. Portia is saying that kindly, I request to you, kindly give me a bond so that I can have a look at it. Shylock, here it is, most reverend doctor, here it is. Shylock is saying that here is the bond. You are a most learned doctor. Take the bond, most learned doctor, and here is the bond. Portia, Shylock, there is twice thy money offered thee. Portia says, Shylock, here is thrice the due amount that is being offered to you. Shylock, an oath, I have an oath in heaven. Shall I lay perjury upon my soul? Not for Venice. Perjury means sin of break. Perjury is a crime which is a sin or a crime which is considered when a person breaks his or her oath. Perjury. Sin of breaking an oath. Sin of breaking an oath. Now, he's saying that Shylock is saying that shall I commit such a grave mistake? That is, shall I commit such a grave crime where I would be committing a sin which would be considered as a sin, because I would be breaking an oath, the oath that I have taken, that if he is not able to give me the money, I will take the bond I will take the flesh from his body. Shall I break my oath for a Venetian man? Shall I break that oath? Shylock is saying, no, not for Venice. I cannot do this, at least for Venice. Portia, why this bond is 4 feet? Why this bond is due? Portia says that this bond is due. This amount is due. And lawfully by this the Jew may claim, and lawfully means according to the laws of Venice, the Jew may stake claim a pound of flesh to be by him cut off, near is the merchant's heart. Be merciful, take thrice thy money, bid me tear the bond. Now Portia is saying that according to my interpretation, it is due, it is mentioned in the law, and according to it, this man, that is the Jew, Shylock, cruel Jew, he is entitled to take a pound of flesh from near Antonio's heart, and then take a pound of flesh from Antonio's heart, and he can stake claim for it. He can actually demand for it, because it is mentioned in the will. And then she says that it is mentioned in the bond, he can stake claim for it. Then he says that she requests Shylock to show some grave mercy towards Antonio. because taking a pound of flesh from any human's body is not at all a merciful act. So she wants Shylock to show some mercy towards Antonio. And then she says, take thrice the money. You take thrice the amount. You take thrice the money. Bid me tear the bond. She is requesting Shylock that though you are entitled to take a pound of flesh from Antonio's body, from near Antonio's heart, but then as an act of mercy, I request you take thrice the money that is being mentioned in your bond, and then give me the permission to tear the bond. Give me the permission to tear the bond. Shylock, when it is paid according to the tenor, when it is paid according to the tenor means according to the terms and the conditions. Tenor means terms and the conditions. Tenor means terms and the conditions. Tenor means terms and the conditions. It does appear you are a worthy judge. Now Shylock is actually trying to polish Portia by saying that it gives me the feeling that you are a most worthy judge. You are a most impartial. Worthy means, worthy over here means impartial, because a judge who gives a fair judgment, who is worthy of being called a good judge, then that judge must be impartial. That is why Shylock is saying that it gives me the feeling that you are one of the most impartial judge. You know the law. You are well versed with law. You know the terms and the conditions of the law. Your exposition had been most sound. Your application of knowledge of law has been very much apt, has been very much sound. I charge you by the law. I charge over here means I request you by the law. I request you by the law, whereof you are a well-deserving pillar, of which you are a epitome, of which you are a pillar, of the law of which you are a representative, a pillar, a strong representative of law. Proceed to judgment, that is, move towards the final judgment. I want judgment, I want decision, and since you are a pillar of that decision, since you are a pillar of that same law, I request you to proceed towards allowing me to get judgment. By my soul, I swear means I take an oath by my soul that there is no power in the tongue of man to alter me, that there is no power, that any human being on this earth has got no power at all to influence me. To influence me means to influence me to change my decision of having a pound of flesh from Antonio's body. I stay here on my bond means I firmly stand with the terms and the conditions of the bond. Antonio, most heartily I do beseech the court to give the judgment. Now Antonio has interrupted because Shylock is reluctant on having the terms and the conditions of the bond. That is why Antonio interprets and says that I request the court, it is my request to the court that give the impartial judgment, and I am here to accept the judgment. Portia, why then? Why again over here means well. Well then, Portia says, well then, thus it is, you must prepare your bosom for his knife. Well then, if you are ready to, for the judgment, then you should prepare yourself. Then you should also be ready to take a pound, to give a pound of flesh away from your bosom, and be ready for the knife of Shylock. Be ready for the knife of Shylock that is going to cut a pound of flesh away from your body. Shylock, O noble judge, O excellent young man, Now Shylock is actually praising Portia because he thinks that Portia is one of a very learned doctor, and she might help him in achieving what he desires. That is the pound of flesh from Antonio's body. Then he says that you are a very noble judge. You are a very learned judge. Oh, excellent young man! You are an excellent young lawyer, Portia. For the intent and purpose, for the scope and purpose of law, for the scope and purpose means for the scope and the reason of law, had full relation to the penalty. Had full relation means was directly related, was actually directly connected to the penalty. If we interpret the law, if the penalty that is going to be paid, the penalty that he is going to pay, that the penalty that Antonio is going to pay, it is actually directly related to the law. Which hair appeareth due upon the bond, and which hair is actually mentioned in the bond, which actually is one of the conditions of the bond. Shylock, 'tis true, O wise and upright judge. Shylock says, since whatever she has spoken up till now as a lawyer, it is actually in the benefit of Shylock only. That's why Shylock says that, O wise and upright judge, and O wise and learned doctor. How much more elder art thou than thou looks? Shylock is actually praising Portia as a lawyer, and he is saying that you are more wiser than your looks, your appearance. You are very young in appearance, but you are very wise in judgment. You are very wise, you are very appropriate in judgment. Portia, therefore, lay bare your bosom. Therefore, uncover your bosom. Portia asks Antonio to uncover his bosom. Shylock, near his chest. So yes, the bond doth it not, noble judge. That is what the bond says. So says the bond, doth it not, noble judge. So that is what is mentioned in the bond. Is it not true, noble judge? Nearest his heart, those are the very words. Nearest his heart means close to his heart, and those are the exact words of the bond. Portia, it is so. Portia says, yes, it is mentioned, it is so, it is so written. Are there balance here to weigh the flesh? Is there any balance, or is there any balance over here means, is there any weighing machine over here, so that from where we can weigh the flesh that will be taken from Antonio's body? Shylock, I have them ready. Yes, I have a weighing machine. I have a balance. I have a weighing machine. Portia, have by some surgeon. Arrange surgeon over here means arrange some doctor. Shylock, on your charge, on your expense, that is, you are going to pay for the doctor to stop his wounds, lest he do bleed to death. To stop means to treat the wound. Once the flesh is taken out from Antonio's body, it will create a wound. To treat that wound, there should be a surgeon over here. Otherwise, he will bleed to death. He will die because he will bleed to death. Shylock, is it so mentioned in the bond? Portia, it is not so expressed, but what of that? It were good you do so much charity. Portia says, no, it is not laid down, it is not being mentioned in the bond that you have to arrange a doctor at your expense. But what about that? It is good that you should do you don't want to do it, because I think it is good to show some act of gratitude. Shylock, I cannot find it. It is not in the bond. I cannot find any such condition in the bond according to which I am entitled to arrange a surgeon for Antonio on my expense. Portia, Come, merchant, have you anything to say? Portia now asks Antonio that come forward, Antonio. Do you have anything to say? Antonio, but little. I am armed and well prepared. For Antonio says, but very little, and I am ready and well prepared. Give me your hand, Bassanio, fare you well. Give me your hand, my friend Bassanio, so that I can say goodbye to you. Grieve not that I am fallen to this for you. Do not be sad. Grieve means do not regret. Grieve means sad or regret. Sad or regret. Grieve not that I have fallen. Grieve not that I have fallen means I am dying because of you. I am dying because of you, because of you. For herein fortune shows herself more kind. Fortune over here is personified. He is saying that for herein fortune as a person shows herself. For in this instance, fortune treats me in a very kind manner. This than her usual custom, than usually it has treated me with. Here on this occasion it has treated me in a very gentle manner than her usual behavior. It is still her use to let the wretched man outlive his wealth. It is still her custom to live the wretched man. To let the poor man outlive his wealth, to view with hollow eye and wrinkled brow an age of poverty, from which lingering penance of such misery that she cut me off. Now, Antonio is saying that it is a custom to let the poor man live after his wealth is to let the poor man live after his wealth is lost, so that in his hollow eyes and wrinkled face show his state of poverty. Usually when people become poor, it is reflected through their eyes and through their appearance. That is why Antonio is saying that it is reflected through that state, their poverty. She has spared me from such a prolonged. She over here means fortune. He's saying that fortune has spared me, has actually granted me, relaxation in bearing such a prolonged suffering. Fortune has actually made an arrangement for me so that I do not suffer for so long. Because when this man is going to take a pound of flesh away from Antonio's body, he is supposing that he will die after some time, after giving a pound of flesh to Antonio. Now we'll stop over here. Now we'll continue from here in our next class. Till then, you all revise this portion, and again we'll meet tomorrow. Thank you so much, children.